Navashiva student, today we are going to start part 34 from chapter 7, System of Particle and Rotational Motion. And this is my today's topic, Torque and Angular Momentum. So, first of all, we have to know what is moment of force or torque. Torque is also known as moment of force or coupling, where a force which acts on a particle and the particle does not move in the direction of a force, but it also turns about some point. So we can say that the torque for a particle about a point as the vector product of the position vector of the point where the force acts and which and with the force itself. So here this is a figure and this is O, this is the point, and this is R is a vector. Now, according to the figure, we can say that torque tau equals to R into F. So here, this is the magnitude of the torque, or you can write this one as tau equals to RF sine theta. If we want to omit that cross part, means cross that part, so we can write that RF sine theta. So RF sine theta, which is that RF sine theta means that is perpendicular. This one is the perpendicular. Now, so R, which is perpendicular distance of line of action of F from the point O. Now, angular momentum of particle. Angular momentum of a particle can be defined as moment of linear momentum about a point. So, angular momentum of a particle, suppose M is a mass with a moving angular moment, mass moving with a velocity v. So, we can write that linear momentum, according to linear momentum, P equals to mv. So if O, that point means O is the point, that point is O. So we can write that O is defined by a following vector product. So we can write that angular momentum L equals to R cross P, where we can write that P equals to mv. So M is a constant term, M R cross V. There is a relationship between torque and angular momentum. So L equals to R cross P or L equals to M R cross V. So here dl dt is what? Ddt of that total part means M R cross V. So ddt of, so M is a constant term. So ddt of R into V plus R into dv dt. So we know that dr dt, that means this one is V. And V cross V is always 0 because this is a cross product according to the rule. So dl dt equals to m r into dv dt. So this is the relationship between angular momentum and torque. Here that part dv dt is a. We know that this is dv dt is a. So we can write this one m r into a. So here r into ma, where ma is the force. So this is the relationship between torque, that angular momentum, and this is a force. So rate of change of angular momentum is dl dt, which is equivalent to torque. So according to Newton's second law of motion in angular form, we can say that rate of change of angular momentum is equal to the torque applied. Now torque and angular momentum of a system of particle. So let me take, there are n number of particles and the angular momentum of the system is the vector sum of the angular momentum of individual particle. Suppose this one L1, L2 plus L3 and so on, this is for the nth particle. So differentiating with the above expression with respect to time, we can write that dl dt equals to summation of that total part I, so dli by dt. So here the summation of I tends to n dli by dt is the net torque on the system, and which is equals to tau net. So Newton's second law of system of particle, which states that the net external force that acting on a system of particle is equal to the time rate of change of system total angular momentum, is equivalent to L. So here tau equals to Ri into Fi, that total part means force for the ith particle, is the vector sum of the external force and of a particle and the internal force of a particle. So we can write that tau equals to summation of that total part, which is external, tau external and internal. Here tau external is Ri into Fi external, and this one is for the internal. Here we know that according to the third law of motion, Newton's third law of motion, tau internal is always 0 and tau external, which is equivalent to tau. So we can write that tau equals to summation of tau I or the total part. So rate of change of angular momentum dl dt equals to tau external. This is very very important derivation. So we can say that the time rate of the total angular momentum of a system of particle about a point is equal to the sum of the external particle acting on the system taken about the same point. This is the conservation of angular momentum, or we can say that dl dt equals to tau net. That part is means tau external is equivalent to zero. So for a rigid body, we can say that for a nf particle, tau external equal to zero. So dl dt is always zero. That means L is the constant term, constant with time. So without any external torque, and angular momentum of a system of particle always remain constant. So here tau external is equivalent to zero, and which is initial, and which is equivalent to when that part angular momentum is conservation. So here L initial is equal to N final. So here L is constant for the three components. Suppose Lx, Ly and Lz, this for the three coordinate, this is constant. So this is all about my today's topic. Tomorrow I will going to start another topic from this chapter. So thank you student for watching this video.